Giving is the anchor of the covenant of financial fortune. But beyond that, quickly listen. Your financial dignity cannot be restored until you return. And how do you return? By putting away iniquity far from your tabernacle. That brings us back again to godliness. The gateway to financial fortune. And put iniquity far from your tabernacle. Stop cheating on people. Stop playing smart on your business partners. Stop playing pranks with your customers. Stop selling fake products. Some are so wicked that they sell fake drugs to kill innocent people for money. It's so important that nobody flows in financial fortune without putting away iniquity from his tabernacle. You think about Job. He was a perfect and an upright man. That's God's testimony. One that feared God and eschewed evil. He was number one in God's sight. He was number one practically. He was a man of integrity to the core. The wife said, "Are you still holding to your integrity? Curse God and die." He was a man of integrity to the core. And he became a generational reverence of financial fortune. You can't assess that realm with bribery and corruption. No. You'll be struggling in the realm here. The good news is this. You cannot be defied without your permission. For the mystery of iniquity doth already work. Only he who now letteth will let until he be taken out of the way. Sin has lost the legal hold on your life since the day you believed. Whatever obtains now is as allowed by you. He says, sin shall no more have dominion over you. For you are no longer under the law, but under grace. He said, I lay before you life and death. That means righteousness and sin. He said, choose life and you shall live. Sin has no legal right over your life anymore. The dominion of sin was terminated when Jesus rose from the dead. The truth is this. Financial corruption is a disqualifier for God's agenda of financial fortune. The two can't go together. I told you the story of Covenant University when we were going to, we were doing verification visit, and the officials came, and then one of them said he wanted to give me some secret information. I said, come. He came to my office. He said, if you don't give something to the chairman and give something to other people through the chairman, the result may never come at that. Stand up, you devil! You think I'm faking it here? His shoe fell off from his feet. It's inside me. It's not. I'm not going to look for it. I wasn't thinking. No premeditation. I didn't know what he was coming to tell me. When I shouted at him, he stood up. His shoe fell off. He went backward. I said, you think I'm faking it here? You devil! Only we can stop corruption.
Yes, sir.
They're already drinking it. Only we can stop it. Defilement in any form will rob you of fulfillment of destiny. The choice is simply yours.